think of the fact that you and your movement were used to attack some Democrats?
The weakness of the ability of the extremists to make their own point. You know, anytime you use somebody that's not even running, whether it's the President Obama or myself, first of all, it's an attempt to distort. And it's a form of race baiting because, no, they never put a picture of the crowd. They try to make it about me. I'm not 80,000, 100,000 people. I'm not 160 organizations. I'm not 100 branches of the NAACP. I'm a servant, pure and simple. That's all I am. But they couldn't put the picture of the diversity. They couldn't show the Republican teacher that stood on the Morrow Monday stage from the West and said that what was going on in cutting of public education was just wrong. They couldn't put the white labor person that was Republican and the black one that was Democrat standing on the stage denouncing the attack on unemployment and earned income tax credit. So what do? You try to create some boogeyman. And it's the same tactic they did with the Racial Justice Act. You remember they put the flyers out with somebody breaking in your house and killing you when they knew that that in fact wasn't happening. It reveals a weak core. You know, if they wanted to debate me, we offered to debate. We said all during tomorrow Monday, Mr. Tillis, Governor, you want to debate us on tomorrow? Not on personal, you know, because all y'all have our personal flaws, but you want to debate us on it? Come on. You won't take that. But what you try to do is sow this kind of race baiting and image baiting and fear baiting. And it really reveals a weakness of your positions because not one of them ran, not one of them put an ad out and said, elect me and I'll take your unemployment. Elect me and I'll fire your teachers. Elect me and I'll deny Medicaid. Elect me and I'll allow children to not have insurance just if they have a pre-existing. They cannot run on their agenda. So they must create distractions. And ultimately, the weakness of this vote, the fact that you had in Wake County, you had a full turnover of the county commission, even though they tried to use us. A few years ago, they tried to use us, and what happened? The whole Board of Education turned over. The fact that they tried that out west and two members of the Republican Party lost in the House. The fact that the only place you had turnover was here in the state of North Carolina, of any state in the country. With all of these attacks, with all of these distortions, the best you can do is 49%. You can't get to 50%. And the best you can do is a little under 50,000. That exposes your weakness. And all we've got to do is continue building. Because the people are not going to fall for that. But again, if I was running an extremist and more exclusive politics, I wouldn't show all the pictures of the people at Morrow Monday either. Right. You know? I mean, it would really work to your disadvantage. Because when you look at Morrow Monday and our movement, you see North Carolina and America in all of its beauty. When you look at the policies and pictures of the extremists and their campaigns, what you see is an homogeneous form of exclusion that is not representative of the full breadth of our democracy. Mm-hmm.